who govern all things both in heaven and on earth. Mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
Christ Jesus, the Lord God, Lord, and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and to the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
In today's gospel, John the Baptist refers to Jesus with a metaphor taken from the Jewish tradition. The Lamb of God is the new pastor who brings deliverance to God's people.
Immediately would think about the sacrifice. because lambs are the perfect animal, the perfect animal for sacrifice. It has some characteristics that makes it the best animal for sacrifice. It says, a lamb is a symbol of meekness and gentleness. Also, a lamb is a symbol of purity and innocence of life. So when John the Baptist calls Jesus a lamb, that will sacrifice himself, who takes away the sins of the world, he refers to the suffering servant of Isaiah. Father, John the Baptist says, I saw the Spirit come down upon me, and I testify. Usually the victims, before they are sacrificed, they are, he says, anointed, they are dedicated, they are consecrated for the sacrifice. That's why the Holy Spirit came upon Jesus and consecrated him, and the Father accepted his sacrifice. This is my beloved son, I am well pleased with his offering. He will pay for all the sins of the world. 3 millennia before Jesus was Abraham, and God once called him Abraham. Yes, Lord. Take your son, the one whom you love, your only one, Isaac. Look, the relationship between Abraham and Isaac is the same relationship between God the Father and Jesus. And the words that the Father says to Jesus at the baptism and the transfiguration are the same. This is my beloved son, my only one. This is, take your son, your only one, the one whom you love, Isaac, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a cart that I will bring up to you. The land of Moriah is in Jerusalem. At that time, there was nothing. It was 3 millennia, 8,000 years before Jesus. If you go to Jerusalem, you will see that there is a big mosque with the golden roof, and inside that mosque there is the stone on which Abraham was going to sacrifice Isaac, and that is in the middle of the temple of Jerusalem, the temple of the Jews. So go to the land of Moriah and offer him as a holocaust. Holocaust was a type of sacrifice that the whole kingdom is consumed. And since thereupon, Abraham took the wood for the holocaust and laid it on Isaac's shoulder at the second station, where the Father put the wood of the cross on Jesus. Isaac was a boy of around 10 years old. Spoke to his father, Father, he said, yes, son, he replied. Isaac continued, here is the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for the holocaust? Imagine, Abraham was his only son, he loved him very much, but God asked to sacrifice him. And he's now asking that, where is the lamb for the holocaust? And Abraham asked, my son, God himself will provide. When they reached the top of the mountain, Abraham tied up his son, putting him on the wood, and stretched his hand with the knife. You will see we have a window there at the back that has that picture. Your faith is huge, it's great. You're going to give it, give your son as you trust in me, something like that. And now comes the divine blessings. Now I promise you, all the peoples of the earth are going to be blessing you, and I will multiply you as the stars of heaven and the sands of the sea, etc., etc. So he is the father of those who believe, because of that sacrifice. But God forgave Isaac. He was not sacrificed. And Isaac said, that where is the lamb? Monsignor Fulton Sheen says that sentence, where is the lamb? Where is the lamb? Remember that question. And later on, as Moses did the Passover and then they procured a lamb for your families and slaughtered them at evening, and we will celebrate the Passover, and then they enter the Holy Land, and they choose Mount Zion, Jerusalem. And the Temple of Jerusalem was the only legal place to offer sacrifices. 3 times a year, all the males over 12 years old had to show up in Jerusalem. And one of those days was from the Passover time. And when they go to the temple, they usually go in caravans. They go in caravans. They make a big caravans, donkeys, a lot of lambs and children. And while they go, for many imagine, you go from here to Houston, go to okay, of course, it's one day to be here. And on the way, they sing the song, I rejoice when I heard them say it as goes to the house of the Lord, our feet are standing within your gates, Jerusalem, etc. But they were here, bringing a lot of lambs. Why? Because they had to offer the sacrifice. If they did not bring the lamb, they had to buy it in Jerusalem. So they had to bring money from their own countries, from their own cities. And when you arrive in a city, the people, the authority in Jerusalem, did not allow to buy without the money from the coins from the city of Jerusalem. So you have the money exchange. And that's why the mafia is changing the money in Jerusalem. And that's why Jesus, you know, take down the tables with the money exchange, because we were not able to buy the animal for the sacrifice, we take the foreigner money. So they beat the lambs on caravans. And one day John the Baptist was in the Jordan River baptizing. Every year at the season of the Passover, he saw that. He saw the caravans with the families and lambs and donkeys and singing. And he also listened to the words of Isaac, where is the lamb? Thousands of lambs are sacrificed every year to atone God, but none of them is enough. Where is the lamb? And once, among the people, he saw Jesus. And he is the voice crying out in the desert, the voice that shouts. He said, behold, very loud, the Lamb of God, the Lamb of God, who will take away the sin of the world, once and for all. Once Jesus was sacrificed, our Passover has been sacrificed, no longer they sacrifice lambs. It is God. And John the Baptist answered to that question of Isaac, and all the people of the Old Testament that were waiting for that suffering Father for the sins of the world. And when the priest at the Mass raised the host and says, "Behold the Lamb of God, blessed are those invited to the supper of the Lamb," he says that taking on the voice of St. John the Baptist, "Blessed are you, because you are invited to this supper of the Lamb." People in the Old Testament were not tables. Jesus, our Passover, has been sacrificed, and you are blessed to be part of that meal. So let us ask our Blessed Mother today that we may deep more and understand all the parts of the Mass, the parts of Holy Scripture, so we, the more we know, the more we can love the Lord. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God for God, light for light, true God for true God, because of not made, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate in the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified and became his Father. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. We present before God our Father our petition.
Pope Francis, Bishop Edward, Bishop Gregory, and all the clergy, that through their ministry all people may experience the tender mercy and steadfast love of God.
We pray.
Thank you.
sing the hymn of your praise as without any preamble. Thank you. that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may pray to invoke us to eternal life, and I praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him. pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those who have noticed by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated again. We have announcements.
Thank you.
Fourth, the Masses ended.
The recessional hymn will be hymn number 606. Hymn number 606.